Today, we have created the perfect 99-rated two-way player, and we're going to follow that man's entire career. Now, you might be asking, RBT, how are you doing this? Let me explain. In simple terms, it all comes down to science. Because if we head into the free agency tab, the highest overall player available, none other than Mr. Johnny Sins, number 69, 99 overall, 20 years of age, and as you guys see, he has everything possible up to 99 overall. Also has superstar X Factor. He went to Salisbury College. Isn't that a steak? But as you see, he's listed as a wide receiver, and let me tell you what we're going to do. We are going to follow this man for 15 years as a wide receiver. And then once the 15 years are up, we're going to reset his age back down to 20 so he doesn't retire and so he doesn't regress. And then for the second and final 15 years, we're going to convert this same man over the defensive end and see if at the end of his 30-year career, he can end up as the best NFL player of all time. Because at the end of this video, I want to see this man in the NFL record books with the most receiving yards all time, with the most receiving touchdowns all time, with the most sacks all time, with the most tackles for loss all time. This man is literally going to end up as the best all-around player in NFL history, and today we're here to follow it every step of the way. So first bit of business, what we need to do is simply just sim 1 week, and I want to see where this man ends up. There's no way, of course. Of course it was the freaking New England Patriots to sign Johnny Sins, dude. That's just so funny. The most disappointing thing, though, is the fact that he had to change his number from 69 to 11. He might not stay with the Patriots his entire career, though, because when they sign out of free agency during the season, it ends up being only a one-year contract, so he might end up being on multiple teams throughout his career. I don't know. I'm excited just to see what the heck happens. So what we need to do now is just go ahead and simply simulate 10 years into the future and see if this man is already within 10 seasons broken every single wide receiver record possible, even though he has another 5 years at the position. But hopefully you guys do enjoy today's video, and if you do, make sure to smash a huge thumbs up. If you guys have any other similar video ideas like this, or any ideas in general for the channel, let me know in the comment section below for a chance for that video idea be turned into an actual video here on the channel. And guys, also make sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new, because if and only if we do hit 1 million subscribers by the end of the year, we're gonna be doing a massive next gen console giveaway to my subscribers and subscribers only. 5 next-gen consoles up for grabs, but that's if and only if we do hit that million mark by the end of the year. So make sure to take that millisecond that does take to click that subscription button if you haven't, so you can have a chance to win one of 5 freaking next-gen consoles. So for now, about 30 minutes for me, about 3 seconds for you. We've made it to the year 2031, and the first bit of business is see where is Johnny Sins playing his NFL football at. Head on over to the NFL tab, and Johnny Sins is with the New York Jets. 10 years into the league, he's now down to 96 feet though, so he's begun to regress a little bit. I'm not able to change any of that. The only thing I'm able to change is his age, but he still looks like an absolute monster, dude. I'm just curious, like, I can't believe he actually started regressing already. Weird for a wide receiver to have wrecking ball, but I'm here for it. Obviously 99 rated, as mentioned, he went to a stake. Now before I forget, I'm gonna go ahead and make that age back down to 20, but this, my dudes, is where things get interesting. We can see how he's performed every single year up to this point in his career. We want to see his contract worth a total of $94 million, a $28 million cap hit. Wait, how is his size rating only 75? He's 7'2", 75, dude. Now to the awards tab. He's made the Pro Bowl 7 times. He got the best wide receiver award, looks like 5 times throughout his career, but that's it. No MVPs, nothing like that. Although you never do see wide receivers win MVP in Madden. But 5 years as the best wide receiver, making the Pro Bowl 7 out of 10 years, isn't shabby at all for the steak man. And career stat time, it looks like he has been with the Jets every single year aside from the first year of his career. But the thing is, it doesn't look like he's been way too crazy. Now, like, keep that in mind, though. I'm talking in terms of relative to being a 99 across the board. Like, he's had 1,000 yards receiving in every single season of his career. That is absolutely insane. And, like, now that I think about it, with 5 more years, he still might be able to end up as the NFL's all-time receiving leader. He still really could. Like, no real crazy, crazy standout seasons. He's been really consistent. I mean, this was his best year, obviously. 1,600 yards, 16 touchdowns. He had 19 touchdowns in 2026. I mean, this guy's gonna break some records. It might not be like the running back video from a few days ago where the guy was running for 2,000 yards a season, but it's still gonna be quite impressive for this guy. We're not even halfway done yet. Now, do want to check out this league history tab and see if he's won any Super Bowls. Chiefs won it in 2021. You had in 2022, the 49ers win the whole thing. The Browns finally win over the Giants in 2023 and 2024. You had the Chiefs win for the 58th time in a row. Oh, there it is. The 59th time in a row. The 60th time in a row. That's so stupid. The 61st time in a row. This is so stupid, dude. Lamar finally wins one. So, yeah, sorry. We didn't win a Super Bowl. The Chiefs have won like 8 out of the last 10. What I actually want to go ahead and do now is simulate to next season because I want to see if he re-signs with the Jets. I would like to give a massive shout out to Honey for sponsoring today's video. And when Honey approached me and wanted to work with the channel, I was like, heck yeah, because dudes, I've been using Honey for years now. Honey is literally the number one shopping tool in America. Literally the easiest way to save money when you make purchases online. Once you get Honey, it's so simple. It literally automatically searches for promo codes every time you purchase something. For this super awesome office chair, Honey automatically found 6 codes, applied one, and just like that, we saved $28.49. Most people don't understand how easy it is. Honey works for things you're already buying at some of the other sites that you already shop at. And every single time over the last few years, I've saved money with Honey. That rhymes. I love it. But seriously, every time I've saved money with Honey over the past few years, it just is so satisfying every time that I get that discount. And you can add Honey to your browser for free. Yes, for free at joinhoney.com/RBT. Once again, that's joinhoney.com/RBT. By doing so, you guys support the channel. And guys, I'm telling you, like, there's no reason not to. You save money. It's free. It's quick. It's easy. Go ahead and click the link in the description box below and get Honey today. Now let's see if the main man is still a New York Jet, and yes, he is. But it does look like he got himself another big contract, and I'm curious to see how big that contract actually was, coming off a 1,300-yard season, 11 touchdowns to the air, which is actually his lowest point in the past, like, 5 seasons. But still had to get a ton of money, right? A 5-year deal once again. I think that's the same exact contract. Like, the same exact contract as last time. 5 years, $92 million. Unfortunately, still not good enough for him to win a Super Bowl. But now it's time to finish off his career as a wide receiver, simming to the year 2036, and see if before he converts to defensive end, he can finish off his career as the best wide receiver in NFL history. But still, so much work for this guy to do. So actually have made it to the end of the 2035 season. I mean, obviously, I would expect him to still be a Jet because he was still under contract unless they traded him, which is really rare, and no, he is still a 99 overall. Crazy enough, though, even though he was reset to 21 years of age, he has not gone up at all. Like, in terms of his ratings, that did regress around his age 30 season initially. But it's sad. His wide receiver career is over, and almost in 2032 did he have his first ever season where he did not have 1,000 yards receiving. It was so close, but obviously, this has got to be some sort of record. Oh no, 2025. How'd I miss that? Only 24 yards over 1,000, but still, what a career for this psycho. Throughout his 15-year career wide receiver, he's made it to the Pro Bowl 11 times. He won best wide receiver 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times. And he still has 1 year remaining on his contract, but it's going to be as a defensive end. Now, before we do convert him, I do have to see, did by chance the Jets win themselves a Super Bowl in the past few years? Unfortunately, no, they haven't. The Ravens have won 23 out of 5 years. And since his wide receiver career is over, I guess it is now time to head into the NFL record book and see if he's rewritten it. Oh, come on. I want to see your name everywhere. Receiving yards. Oh no. Finishes second all time. That's so unfortunate, bro. That just shows you how crazy Jerry Rice actually is, man. Like, Johnny Sins did not have one season where he didn't have 1,000 yards receiving, and he still finishes 3,000 yards behind Jerry Rice. Some other guys up there, wow, Terry McLaurin, Stephon Diggs, DeAndre Hopkins, Devontae Adams, Mike Evans up there. We've at least got to have broken, like, the receiving touchdown record, right? No, we didn't. Oh, that's so unfortunate. I am so sad, bro. One touchdown less than Jerry Rice. That is so sad. Well, some of the other guys up there, Devontae Adams, Tyreek Hill, Mike Evans, Larry Fitz, but I'm a little disappointed. Like, I guess if you're going to be second anything, to be second to Jerry Rice, I mean, that's pretty good territory for John. Wait, did he not even finish in the top 10? Wow, he didn't even finish in the top 10 of career receptions, which is still pretty impressive to finish your career second most all-time receiving yards and touchdowns and not finish in the top 10 of catches. How about per season, though? Receiving yards? No, it's Calvin Johnson. Did we at least come not even in the top 10 receiving touchdowns? At least we came third all time with 19 touchdowns in 2026. Like, imagine this guy if he was actually on a good team throughout his career. Why did it have to be the Jets? Didn't necessarily rewrite the record books today, but he at least did put his name up there. But now it's time for this man to transform. What are the Jets? A little help here. They have an 82 rated left end, and at right end they have a 90 rated. So we'll make Johnny Sins a left end for the sake of the Jets. Like, this guy is gonna be an absolute monster. 96 speed coming off the edge and 7 foot tall, 275. But first, we do have to make sure he does go through the hyperbolic time chamber so he doesn't retire on us. Johnny Sins, you did great at wide receiver, but man, your career is just getting started. Halfway through, now converted to defense to solidify himself as the best overall player in NFL history. As you see, he's still a 99 rated defensive end. What sort of abilities does this guy have? He has inside stuff and rippers, so safe to say he's gonna be good. So what that means, all we have to do now, simulate 10 years into the future. So another 30 minutes for me, about 3 seconds for you. We've made it 2045. Time to see how this man is done as a defensive end in the league. Was he as dominant as he was as a wide receiver? Now, the question is, do the Jets want to keep him around as a defensive player, or do they only like him as a wide receiver? Jets look like they no longer have this man on their roster. The question is, where did he end up? Johnny Sins is now back with the Patriots. Can you sign for somebody else, bro? But as you see, 99 rated. He has like the same exact rating, so they haven't regressed and they haven't gotten better in the past 10 years. Now, he's made it to the Pro Bowl 15 times, but look at this dude. He's led the league in sacks for 9 consecutive seasons. He's the best D lineman in 2040, 2037, 2041. He had the Defensive Player of the Year in 2040. Best D lineman 2039, 2036. Defensive Player of the Year again. Best Defensive Lineman. Just look at all these accolades, dude. Look at that. Look at that, bro. He's won Defensive Player of the Year. Like, is that every year so far? Now we move on to career stats, and this man... What is that? What are we doing? That is insane, dude. It looks like he's been with the Patriots. This will be his 4th season, but he's averaging about 32 sacks a season. That's like the craziest thing I've ever seen, dude. So it looks like you could be a lot more dominant of a defensive end than wide receiver in the NFL as a 99 rated. This man has got to have broken almost every single defensive record possible in terms of like QB pressure, sacks, tackle for losses, that kind of stuff. Like, that's literally crazy. He's getting over like 100 tackles a season at defensive end. Big question though, he has gotten 2 picks in his career. That's funny too. And he has scored as a defensive player too. This man, easily best player of all time. Like, that is just so wild. He got over 40 sacks in a season, you weirdo. Now, did he finally get to win a Super Bowl? That's the main question. Jags won it, Titans lost. We've at least made it to a Super Bowl. Vikings have won it a few years in a row. They went to 4 straight Super Bowls. My Titans actually won one in 2039. So I'll be about 49 years old by the time they win a Super Bowl. Vikings with another one. Bucks win one, 2036. The Vikings with one again. Ravens win another one. So yeah, poor guy has been the best player of all time by a landslide, but yet he's never even appeared in a Super Bowl because his team sucked. Like, how do you get a guy individually getting 40 sacks a year and not at least make it to one Super Bowl? So what we're going to go in and do is actually reset his age back down to like 24, 23, and we're going to simulate 4 final seasons before franchise mode does end, and see how many career sacks this crazy boy ends up with. We've made it to the final year of franchise mode, 2049, and the question is the main man still a member of the New England Patriots, or did he go back to the freaking Jets at the end of his contract? If he did, this is funky. Is John still a Patriot? Of course he is. Still a 99. His stats have remained the same, but I'm sure he's still been insane. So he does have about 2 years left on his contract, about $22 million a year. Awards, he's ended up with 15 Pro Bowl, so he's made the Pro Bowl about 1 every 2 seasons in his career, a little bit less than 1 every 2 seasons. He's led the league in sacks for 13 seasons, which I think is like every single season, which I just can't read all this out, bro. Like, there's just so many awards this man won. I mean, it's just so funny. You see defensive player of the year, then you see best freaking wide receiver sprinkled in there. Let's do it. The most important thing here, career sacks. He has continued to average about 35 sacks a season. Still hasn't topped that 2042 year when he had 41 and a half sacks sacks in one single season. But when your career low when you actually started on defense is 26 and a half sacks a season, you've had a pretty good freaking career, John. The guy to have at least one Super Bowl, though, please, just one. Ah, he made it to one, but unfortunately, he didn't win it. Not in 2045. Yeah, poor guy. How do you end up the best player ever, by far, and not win one Super Bowl? At least they made it to one. Now, this is where I'm so excited to look, dudes. The NFL records, defensive sacks. Oh, my God. God, that is crazy. Well, to be fair, Bruce Smith is the one that really leads with the most sacks in NFL history, and Johnny Sins more than double Bruce Smith's record. Funny enough, Chase Young ended up with 199, 437 total sacks in 15 seasons, in half of his career. And I fully expect to look at this right here, and he's gonna be all top 10. Yep. Safe to say, Mr. Sins was quite the baller. He's probably gonna go retire and become, I don't know, like an astronaut or teacher or something.